Okay, so last time we have seen what you mean by surface tension. So we have seen for surface tension is nothing but force per unit length. Now here the next topic we are going to see about surface energy. So just recall previous knowledge, whatever we have seen in our last lecture, that is in surface tension. We have seen about the molecular theory of surface tension. In that we have seen three molecules of water. Suppose this is my glass beaker and this is my surface of water. So we have seen three molecules at three different positions. So one molecule was A, which was completely inside the liquid. Second B, which was the larger part of B was lying inside the liquid, and 30% part was lying outside the liquid. The C molecule was half outside the liquid and half inside the liquid. This was B and this. These three things we have seen. I have drawn the rough diagram here just to know you, just to recall you what we have seen last time. So this all three molecules we have seen. This was the imaginary sphere of influence around them. Now, today, in today's topic about the surface energy, we are going to see what do you mean by surface energy and how it acts. Let's say I will consider only the molecule which was completely deep inside the liquid, that is A. Now, as we know, the property of surface tension means it is minimizing the surface area, this. So, I can see the less number of molecules are present at the surface. Because last time we have seen the maximum molecules which are present on the surface will try to reduce the surface area and come down in downward direction. So now to take the water molecules at the surface to maximize the area of the surface, or I can say to maximize the surface area, I need to take the water molecule at the surface. Now if I want to take this water molecule at the surface, I need to do some work. So when I'm doing some work means there is some potential energy. Because work done is stored in the form of potential energy. Means here I can say my potential energy is minimum. There is no need to do any work. But when I am trying to take this molecule from bottom till the surface of your liquid, I need to do some work done. Means I need to apply some potential energy. Means at this surface, when this molecule comes here, it has maximum potential energy because maximum work done is done here. So, whatever the molecule has energy, that is extra energy present on the surface is known as surface energy. So, it is one form of potential energy, or you can say it is one form of work done which is needed to take the molecule from bottom till the surface of your liquid to maximize the area. And as you know, as we take the molecule from bottom till the surface, you need to do some work done. So at bottom, I will say my potential energy is minimum. As I go up and reach at the surface, my potential energy is maximum. So I can say in other words, the molecule present on the surface of the liquid has maximum potential energy. So maximum potential energy, in other words, I can say there is some extra energy present with the molecule when they are present at the surface of your liquid, and that extra energy is known as surface energy. So I hope this topic is clear to you that surface energy is nothing but the potential energy of the molecule which are on the surface. And always remember, the molecules which are present on the surface has higher potential energy, that is maximum potential energy. So this is what surface energy means. Now, you have one derivation in your textbook, that is the relation between surface energy and surface tension. So, we will derive now. So, relation between surface energy and surface tension. So, before deriving, We'll draw a diagram. So let's consider a rectangular frame here. This is my rectangular frame. So we'll label it P dash P, S dash S. I have labeled according to your textbook. So P dash P, S, S dash, this is my rectangular frame. So I can say side P dash P is fixed, it is not moving. Side P S is also fixed, it is not moving. Side S, S dash is also fixed, it is not moving. Only I have one side, which is my fourth side of the rectangle, which is movable, that is side QR. Now, this QR has, this side has length capital L. Now, as it is movable, so I can move it in any direction. But, this is now a completely hollow rectangular frame when I dip it in a soap solution. So, you have soap film. In this region, the soap film is created in this region, that is PQRS. Now, as there is a soap film, it will have surface tension. Means there will be a force acting on the surface of this film. That force will try to minimize its area. So, I will say this is my force F, which is acting in inward direction, which is trying to minimize this area. And this side, that is QR, will try to move in direction of PS. So, now if I want to maximize this area, means if I want to move this QR side to some distance, say BX here. So I will say, if I move this QR side to some distance BX, at the position 2 dash R dash. So what will happen? This soap film will get here. It will spread and it will occupy the space, right? But while moving this from R to R dash or Q to Q dash, whatever the force which is acting in inward direction towards PS because of surface tension, same force I need to apply but in opposite direction. So only it can move in direction of Q dash and R dash. So here, whatever force I require here, whatever force is acting here because of surface tension, same amount of force, same magnitude of force I need to apply in opposite direction. I will name it as F dash, which will be in opposite direction. So after applying with a small displacement dx, I will extend this frame and I will try to maximize the area. Now, this force which is acting in inward direction will be nothing but the force due to surface tension, and we already know the formula for surface tension is force per unit length. So, this is a force acting here. So, I can write this force is nothing but T into L. Now I will insert here 2. Why 2? Because we have two surfaces of this frame. One is upper and one is lower. So one back side and one front side. Because of these two surfaces, here we need to insert 2, because whatever force is acting on this length L is because of two surfaces. One is front and one is back. You can see one is upper and second is lower. So this two factor comes here. So total force acting in inward direction, that is due to surface tension, will be 2TL. Now, as I move this frame by the force F dash, by the small displacement dx, so while moving this side QR, I need to do some work done. So that work done, that small amount of work done, I can write by the formula, that is work is nothing but force into displacement. So small work done, that is dW, can be written as force. What is that force? F dash into displacement, that is dx. But as we know, this force, the magnitude of this F dash force is same as of F. And what is the value of F? F is nothing but 2TL. So I can insert it, instead of F dash, I can insert the value of F because both are having magnitude same. So here it can be 2TLTX. Now if I take here T aside and write 2LDX as it is. So L into DX, this L into DX will give me area. What is that area? That is nothing but increase in surface area. So L into DX will be nothing but area. 2LDX means what? We are considering the area of two surfaces, front and back, or upper and lower. So 2LDX will give me the increase in surface area. So I can write, instead of 2LDX, I can write DA, which is nothing but increase in surface area on both these sides, lower and upper. So this is my total work done. Now once you get total work done here, this work done is always stored in the form of potential energy. As we are calculating everything on the surface of your film, so this work done is nothing but stored in the form of potential energy. So I can write potential energy is equal to T into dA, that is surface tension into increase in surface area. Once I got this, as we have seen just before, the potential energy at the surface is stored in the form of surface energy. So I can call this potential energy as surface energy. So I can write surface energy is equal to TdA. So the relation between surface energy and surface tension is nothing but surface energy is equal to surface tension into increase in surface area. From this, we can get the other definition of surface tension, that is T can be written as surface energy per unit increase in surface area. So this is another formula for surface tension. So this is a relation between surface energy and surface tension. A small derivation which can be asked for 2 or 3 marks. Maximum 3 marks, minimum 2 marks. So this is a very good derivation which shows the relation between surface energy and surface tension. I hope you have understood this. Thank you.